So the film is based in Coorg. It's a very picturesque coffee country of Karnataka. A lot of coffee estates, and these Coorgis have their own distinct lifestyle. You know, their lifestyle is very different, and very few people in India know about Coorgis and Coorg culture, which is very rich in its culture. And incorporating all that nativity, that culture, I've woven a story which is really good. It's a story about four principal characters and their psychological this thing. So it's a film. That's why I've aptly named it Blood Story. I hope that this film will give a lot of uniqueness, a lot of new dimension to Hindi film industry. And with that, this thing in our heart, we have set out to make that film. And Kshanambika Film Craft is a company which is founded by Mr. Lakshmi Narayan. We aim to produce very meaningful yet entertaining films in future. Goal is not just Bollywood, even we want to venture into Hollywood as well. And we got the resources to do that. So Mr. Lakshmi Narayan, who's very passionate about films, though he's his first film, he heard the story and he said, since it reflects our culture, the culture of Coorg and the culture of Karnataka, and it introduces that culture to the whole world and to India, so let me be part of it. And then we came to Bombay, then we were scouting for talent, then I met Lopa. I told her the story, and she was also like, you know, looking for a kind of film to be launched at the right launching project. So she liked it immensely, and so I hope it will be a very fruitful and wonderful journey together. And my friend, Mr. Madhukar Gowda, is be the associate producer of this film. So this is about it, Blood Story. And we have ventured out, and we need all your support because it's a new team wanting to do some new things in a proper way, in a right way. So now Mr. Lakshmi Narayana will speak about the project, and then Lopa will speak to you. Then we'll take your questions.
It is a suspense thriller. It is something, when I was listening to the story, he's very smart. You know what he did? He narrated me the half story first. And every time I met him, I asked him, what is the other half? You have to tell me, because every time I kept thinking, when I thought about the movie, what would have possibly happened after that? Iske baad kya hua hoga? Aur wo sawal jo mere man mein tha, maine ek audience perspective dekha, audience point of view socha, aur maine socha, this is actually a good project to be in because it keeps you so intrigued. Every time he was narrating a story, I was like this, on the edge of the seat, thinking, what next? Ab kya hone wala? And every time I expected something, something absolutely different happened. So nothing like a project like this, you know. And it's a suspense thriller, which generally always does well. So I'm very happy to be a part of it, and I'm very, very, very excited.
You have taken a long time after Bigg Boss. You have done Khatron Ke Khiladi, but for Bigg screen, you have taken time. So any particular reason behind this, or you are waiting for right script?
First thing is that I always knew that I want to do movies when I came out of the Bigg Boss. So I was very clear in my mind that movies is my thing and this is what I want to do. Secondly, there were a lot of projects that came to me immediately after I came out of the house, and I literally let four or five movies go. My manager's right here, and she used to tell me, Lopa, what's wrong with you? Why are you letting these projects go? It's not a wise thing to do. You should just take whatever comes your way. But I'm very selective. I've always been very picky in terms of my choices, and I've been very clear. So that's where I can connect with what Hemant sir says, because he's very clear in what he talks about. He's very crisp. So that's how I felt about my career, and this is what I want for myself. And I thought that I have to do this kind of project in which the story is good. Because in this story, you know, the story is the hero, and that's what we want. I really don't care how I look like in the movie, how the director makes me look like. The story has to be intriguing enough for audience to appreciate everybody's effort. And I think that's a win-win situation. So when I heard this story, I thought that I should do it. So no regrets. I think, and always, like you said, bought time liya, gap liya. So I'd like to answer that by saying good things take time, you know.
से पहले आप फैन रही हैं हिचकॉक की फिल्मों की?
very honestly, मैं इस movie को किसी के साथ compare नहीं करना चाहती हूँ क्योंकि जब मैंने ये देखा एक comparison as in एक milestone बहुत अच्छी बात रहेगी but जैसे मैं sir को भी compliment करती हूँ कि this movie in itself is very unique. Yes, we obviously can you know tell that this is a lot according to that genre. इस genre की movie है but when he tells me about the story, I cannot think of any other movie because I have never seen a movie like this before. So, which itself is a compliment to you, sir. So, yeah.
Hemant, इस पोस्टर में हम देख रहे हैं कि खास तौर पे हिचकॉक की फिल्मों की याद आती है.
Yeah. See the whole poster, no? It's pencil sketch. It's drawn by an artist. So we have a lot of thought has gone into it. If you there's a lot of things which this poster says, you know, there are some hidden things which it says, and there are some obvious things which it says. So even the film, no, I want this film to be a film which is steeped in a culture and nativity, yet extremely entertaining. You know, that kind of a storytelling pattern what I'm trying out is probably new for Bollywood also. Because it's an extremely new kind of a storytelling pattern that I'm telling, and it will be very intriguing. So in that way, I wanted my posters to reflect what the film will look like. You know, how unique it will be and how classy it will be. So that's why this poster. And we have taken a lot of pain to create this.
Okay. Yeah. Are you planning to release this in Kannada also?
No. It's a straight Bollywood. Because you know what happened? I've done around 8 films. Out of 8, 3 have been remade into Bollywood officially. 4 have been made it unofficially. So I thought this time I'll directly come to Bollywood.
And which is your favorite film from Hitchcock?
Mine is Vertigo.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Sir, hi.
Yeah.
The poster itself, it feels like kuch nayapan hai, you know, when we saw the first look over
okay,
here.
Okay.
The idea, the concept behind this, how did the idea actually strike you?
See, I wanted to I have one concept about filmmaking. It's almost 99% it is proved right. Yeah, unless you excite that interest in an audience from the first look, people won't come. Afterwards, you put posters in front of every household in Bombay. How much ever you spend, if you don't ignite that excitement in the beginning of the movie, people are not excited. People don't come to the theaters. So from the beginning, a film has to make a statement. That statement took me to this path where I thought what, you know, unique could be done, which will reflect my film also, the personality, the genre of the film also, and which is unique also. You know, this poster, if I put it in any this thing, anybody who's driving a car will at least stop and look. Are kya hai ya? That concept I wanted to bring, and the film will also be like that, you know. That uniqueness will be there in the film.
And we would also like to hear something about Lopa's association. How easy or difficult was it to shoot with Lopa?
No, Lopa had her doubts. I'll be very frank because it's her debut and she's trusting me completely. It's a very big responsibility because she must have had hundreds of offers and out of that she has chosen this one. And with that trust, my responsibility also grows. You know, I have to live up to that trust. And I was very frank with her. I told her in the first place, see, Lopa, it's not about your role or other girl's role or other guy's role. It's about the whole film. We'll have to work as a team and the whole film should win. And it should be win-win for all of us. So that's how she came on board. And to be very honest, she's got a good script sense. I was really amazed and I was a little apprehensive whether she'll do this role or not in the beginning. But then she told me one good thing, sir, this film, overall film is important. So if I want to be part of a good film, so I'm on board. So I really liked it.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Also, to the producer of the film. So producing a film is always a difficult task. You know, we have been hearing this since a long time. Aapne aisa kya dekha script mein that you wanted to be a part of the project?
Yeah, see, in this totally film, you know, there is a different concept in the movie. Okay, so totally each character has different, you know, segments. In this concept, you know, we thought of introducing the, you know, Kurk culture. Everybody has different, you know, role, different, you know, what you call, dressing style and everything. That's how I thought of introduce this movie in a Bollywood.
नो नो, कोई सच्ची घटना नहीं है, जो मेरे माइंड पे घटना है उस पे आधारित है.
हेलो.
Yeah,
I'm Smritika from Television's World.
Okay.
Like Lopamudra is your first choice or like some other actress? Of
no, I had a. You won't believe it, but she was the first choice because from the day I saw her in Bigg Boss, I thought this girl has some spunk. You know, she had that thing. So I was waiting for a right script also, and it so happened that one of the coordinators made us meet, and then clicked from the first meeting. Then I said, we were supposed to do a Kannada film together before, and almost it had finalized, but unfortunately that project didn't happen. So then when I came up with this concept, then I thought she suits the role to a T. So then, yeah, it happened.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm still not there. I'm just stepping in now. So I'm very excited, though I've tasted a little bit of it through the various shows that I've done. And yeah, I enjoyed it a lot. And you know, if you see my life's graph or my career graph from where I begin, it started completely on a different note. It started from pageants, Miss India, then went to a reality show genre, where I did Bigg Boss, then I did Khatro Ke Khiladi, Fear Factor. And now I'm coming into movies. So for me, it's like a wonderful journey where I'm enjoying each bit of it. And I'm just looking forward to so much more to do and so many more projects. So yeah, I'm very, very excited for this. And also I'd like to tell that this week has been super, super lucky for me because this is the second movie I've signed in like within 7 days. My manager's there. I was just telling her she's more excited than I am. So yeah. So but this movie will be my debut. This will come first and the other will come later. So I'm super excited. I can't tell you how much. Yeah. Any other question? Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, the film is Blood Story, set in picturesque surroundings of Coorg, setting of Coorg. Actually, this Coorg is the coffee county of India, a very vibrant place. Coorgis are very vibrant people, and they've got their own unique culture. And having that culture, I mean, using that culture and I've built a story, woven a story around that culture and that creativity. And yet it's very entertaining. It's an edge of the seat thriller. It's a thriller like Kahani, where you get entertained, you get a message, and also you get, you go out of the theater with a wholesome feeling, like achi film dekhi. So it's that kind of a film. So where logic is totally maintained and the suspense is of awesome. So attempt is to give a very unique flavor to Bollywood, which it has not seen. So that's what Blood Story is all about.
So Blood Story, my first film obviously, and I'm very excited about it. And the fact that it's a suspense thriller makes it a more intriguing project to work with. And I would like to tell you that when I was listening to the story, he's a very good narrator, let me tell you. He got me convinced for this role and how. Because he knows what he's talking, he's very clear about what he's saying. And the way he narrates, you can actually picturize everything in front of your eyes. So the story revolves around four lead characters, four main characters. It's a psychological suspense thriller which keeps an audience right on the edge of the seat throughout the movie. So every time you guess, oh, this is what's going to happen next, this, and you're wrong. Every time I tried to guess, I was wrong. So I just left my everything. I left my wits on the side. And I completely just listened to him. And I got so intrigued when I was listening to this story. And I thought it is a project to do. So I'm very excited about this project. And also the fact that it will be my debut film.
कौन सी ऐसी एक चीज़ थी जो आपको स्क्रिप्ट की तरफ अट्रैक्ट किया या फिर क्या यूएसपी थी
इस फिल्म की? स्टोरी इसकी यूएसपी है और जो हमारे कैरेक्टर्स हैं इस मूवी में और जिस तरह के किरदार वो निभाने वाले हैं, जिस तरह की स्टोरीज उनके कैरेक्टर के इर्द गिर्द घूम रही है, वो भी मतलब इट्स लाइक एन अमलगमेशन ऑफ एवरीथिंग पुट टुगेदर दैट मेक्स इट अ वेरी गुड स्टोरी. एंड आई थिंक फॉर मी अ स्टोरी हैज़ टू बी गुड, द कैरेक्टर हैज़ टू बी गुड, and the director has to be good. And I think this movie offered me all of those above. So yeah.
Right, Lopa, ये आपकी पहली film है और जो भी actress होती है अपनी love story से शुरुआत करती है या फिर horror film से, तो आपने किसी से suggestion लिया था first film के लिए या फिर किसी से पूछा था कि मुझे किस तरह की film करनी चाहिए, अगर उस बारे में क्या thought process था?
हमारे पास बहुत सारी stories आई, बहुत सारी हमने scripts पढ़ी है. We used to sit on every project and think if we should do it or not. But this film, I convinced, like I told my people that I want to do this because I like it personally. So I'm very intuitive that way. I'm very, मैं बहुत सारे decisions अपने हाथ से लेती हूँ और बाद में अपने mind को लाती हूँ. यहाँ पे मेरा heart और मेरा mind दोनों sync में था जब मैंने project करने का decide किया. So yeah.
Mr. Narayan, proud to be associated with the project.
Yeah, definitely.
क्या कुछ तो सर प्लीज कहिए
आप.
Yes, Chris, one word. To the point. So I wanted to give the good message to the society, you know, so making good films, and also we have a future plans to enter into the Hollywood also. And the story is very good and totally suspense, as director said and also Lopa said, and it's a different characters and also new culture for the, you know, Hollywood and also Bollywood. We are planning to release this you know, film in 36 countries. 1,200 screens also we are planning it. First film, you know. And also it's a very good, you know, coming to the Bollywood from South. I'm very excited about this.
Okay. Lopa, crimes against women continuously increasing in India. How do you see this crimes increasing in India? Women's like rapes, child rapes increasing. Yeah. What is your take on?
I think the law has to be really strict. The reasons why we have a lot of criminals is because the criminal thinks in his mind, I think, that until the law and the justice comes, it's going to take years and years for, you know, for the judge, like, because obviously that's the reason, the population is one of the reasons that we take a lot of time to give a judgment or any juristic or any, what do you call it? What's the right word to say?
Any verdict about
the criminal. We take a lot of time. So I think in the meanwhile, the criminal just fizzles out and, you know, he thinks that he'll flee, he'll just flee to some country. That's what is happening in our country. I think the law has to be really strict, like other countries. Like somebody who attempts a rape should be hanged to death. I think that it should be brutal.
Women should be respected. That should be taught to people. I mean, from the childhood, you know, women are to be respected.
Yes,
girls are to be respected.
Our moral values, especially in the house where a boy child takes birth, the moral values to the child has to be really strong. He should be taught to respect a woman. He should be taught not a woman is not a plastic doll he'll play with, or you know, that should be the mentality of a guy when he's growing up. And the judgment and the verdicts that are taken on the criminals, punishment should be really firm, and it should be really rapidly taken without giving any chance for that criminal to just leave the country or think that he'll keep doing crimes and get away with it. That shouldn't be the thought. It should be really brutal for a rapist. The punishment should be that brutal that any other guy who even thinks of committing a rape should shiver with fear of the punishment. Even before committing it, that should be the brutality.
Yeah.
We are planning for a January release, next January. So it's a start to finish project. So down south, we make films little real quick, you know, and more professional also. So we are planning to do it by January, mid-January.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.